radio and TV host, Mike Sutherland.
Oh, and I got the music too. That's a beauty. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2013 edition of the Coach of the Year Award in the Canadian Football League. Mesdames et messieurs, bienvenue à l'édition 2013 du remise du trophée pour l'entraîneur-chef de l'année dans la Ligue canadienne de football. Great to see so many of you here today. Those of you who are visiting us from other CFL cities, welcome. For those of you that are coming back, welcome back to the capital. I'm sure you've noticed that there's quite a buzz and quite an energy surrounding the return of football here in the capital. The Red Blacks making preparations to be on the field. Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Making preparations to be on the field this summer. I guess my message to those of you who will be returning in the summer and the fall is enjoy the quiet time that you're experiencing right now, because there's a good chance that when you come back in the fall, it's going to be quite a bit louder. Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, we're here to give away the Annis Stukus Award given to the head coach of the year in the Canadian Football League. We've been treated to another fantastic season of Canadian football in 2013. Fantastic games, exciting finishes. I'd like to bring up as our first speaker today the commissioner of the Canadian Football League, Mesdames et Messieurs, le commissaire de la Ligue canadienne de football, Mr. Mark Cohan.
Bonjour and bienvenue. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, everyone, for coming out today. Obviously, you can see the big smile on my face. We are so excited about bringing CFL football back to the nation's capital and welcoming the Red Blacks into the league. It is truly an exciting time. And what I want to do, first and foremost, is start off by saying thank you. I want to thank the leadership at the Ottawa Sports and Entertainment Group for having the vision to bringing CFL football back here. So if the guys are in the room, please stand up and recognize them. Please, a lot of them here, but they deserve it, wherever they may be. Great job, guys. I want to thank many of the political leaders here from the municipality, from the city, from the province, and from the federal government who support the CFL and support our return to the nation capital. I also want to thank the business and community leaders here who are here to support the Red Blacks and the return to the nation's capital. You know, without your support, we would not be successful, and I know this franchise is already off on, with a great start. You know, think of the quarterbacks that they have. With so many leaders in the room, maybe what I should do is take a few minutes to talk about leadership and share my thoughts on leadership. And I thought what would be appropriate is to quote a great man that the world lost this past year, Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela once said, I want to read this because it's quite important, it's better to lead from behind and put others out front, especially when you celebrate victory when nice things occur. You take the front line when there is danger, then people will appreciate your leadership. Now, it would be ludicrous for me to compare the struggles and triumphs of Nelson Mandela with that of football, but when you think about that quote, and you think about what he said, it really does pertain to the three gentlemen that we honor today. When their team loses, and the fans are angry, and the media is unhappy, and maybe a little bit grumpy, these guys are the first ones to take the front line. They will say, there are no excuses. We need to do better, and I need to coach better. But when there is victory and they're ready to celebrate, they will praise their players, they will praise the 13th man and thank them for being as loud as they can, and they will praise their assistant coaches. Think of these gentlemen, Ken Austin. Kent could have blamed injuries or youth or the fact that they really didn't have a home stadium while Tim Horton Field was being built. Instead, he led his team to the Grey Cup in his first year as a head coach with the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Think of John Huffnagel. John watched as all-stars went down throughout the year and throughout the season. But instead of making excuses, he had the best record in the league in 2013. And Corey Chamberlain, think of the obstacles and the ups and downs he had to endure throughout the year and the challenges of making Rider Nation happy. Well, today he is the beloved son of Saskatchewan and a Grey Cup champion. So clearly, Ken, John, and Corey understand what it means to lead. And gentlemen, I know you're all there. As Mandela puts it, we truly appreciate your leadership. Congratulations to each and every one of you. Good luck today, and good luck in 2014.
Commissioner Cohan, ladies and gentlemen. Well, let's get right to our three finalists. Commissioner Cohan mentioned the three coaches that we're here to honor today. One of them will walk away with the Annis Stukus trophy that you see right here. So in his first season as head coach of the Hamilton Tiger Cats, our first finalist led his team all the way to the Grey Cup. Ladies and gentlemen, head coach, general manager, vice president of football operations for Hamilton Tiger Cats, Kent Austin.
The demolition of Iverwind Stadium to make way for the new Tim Hortons Field on the same grounds forced the Tiger Cats to move to a temporary home up the road in Guelph. And in their first game at Alumni Stadium, Mother Nature greeted the Tiger Cats with a torrential downpour, as the weather would become a recurring theme throughout the season. Turning a new page in his coaching career, Austin would have to open up memories of a previous chapter in Week 4. And returned to Regina for the first time since leading the Riders to a Grey Cup title in 2007. The Tiger Cats received tremendous support from one group which had been with them through thick and thin, the fans. The Tiger Town faithful transferred all that energy that made Iverwind Stadium one of the toughest places to play and brought it to Guelph. Austin led the Tiger Cats to a 10-8 record, the team's first winning season in 10 years. The East semifinal saw the Tiger Cats finish their season in Guelph just like they started it, with Mother Nature throwing everything she had at them. The Tiger Cats fought windy conditions and defeated Montreal 19-16 in overtime. Playing in their first East final in 14 years, Austin, the Tiger Cats, and their fans took the trip down the QEW to Toronto and overcame a 14-point deficit, scoring 26 straight points, and defeated the Argonauts 36-24. Advancing to their first Grey Cup since winning it all in 1999.
We're going to the top! This group in here proved to the whole country, right, what you guys are made of.
Despite losing to the hometown Rough Riders in the Grey Cup game, Austin has been putting the building blocks in place with the Tiger Cats, just as workers are building the infrastructure of Hamilton's brand new stadium, giving the Tiger Cats fans a lot to look forward to in 2014.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage head coach of the Hamilton Tiger Cats, Mr. Kent Austin. Okay. Coach, obviously got a great history behind you in football, in the Canadian Football League as well. We lost you to the States a couple of times as a coach. You came back again this year. What keeps bringing you back to the CFL?
Well, there's a lot of things, right? It's it's different for every coach that coaches. Some of it's personal, some of it's professional. And just had a great opportunity to come back to a great organization, great leadership. It's been pretty well documented with Bob as the owner and Scott, a guy that I had a long relationship with for many years, and an opportunity to get back to an area of the country that we love, and quite frankly, to get back to a league that has a way of pulling you back in.
Doesn't it? It does.
It's a special league with a lot of great coaches, two of the greatest coaches in the league right now that I'm here with tonight, this afternoon. That's the same throughout the rest of the league, right? Just a lot of talented coaches, a lot of talented football players, a unique game that's uniquely Canadian. Exactly, yeah. Just it's got the right feel to it, and it's good for your family as well.
Coach, you've had the quarterback touch everywhere you've gone. Damon Allen, Kerry Joseph. You have an opportunity this year. Dan LeFever played quite a bit this year. You add Zach Caleros into the mix now. What do you see in him that makes you excited about working with this young quarterback?
We saw in Zach a proven winner, a young man that clearly has excelled at every level. When he's been given an opportunity, he's performed. This year, he was able to win in a lot of very difficult situations, especially going on the road, win 4 games in a row. He's got a strong desire to be great. He's a hard worker. He'll pay the price in the film room. He'll pay the price in the weight room. He's a natural leader. He's endearing to his players, so he draws people in. That's for starters.
That's the tip of the iceberg. That's a pretty good iceberg.
Yeah, right? He's a really quality young man. We're excited to have him.
Coach, we saw in the video, not an easy season for you guys, kind of getting kicked out of your home at the then Ivor Wynne Stadium. Tim Hortons Field set to be completed for the new season coming up. How excited are you to get back home, I guess, in front of your people?
We're real excited. Yeah, we're real excited.
There's a real energy about that place.
Yeah, there is. And, you know, our fans were great this year coming out to Guelph and supporting us. And the organization did such a great job in really trying to, they really did an outstanding job of making that our home, right, for the year. And helping our, you know, helping our players buy in and the fans buy in. But we're excited to have the new stadium open up.
And
yeah, so it's an exciting time, you know, to be with Hamilton and, you know, just a privilege to be there.
Coach, great season this year. All the best. Best of luck today for the
award.
Thank
you. Thanks everybody.
Get Austin, everybody. Our next finalist won the Grey Cup this year. You all know who it is. And did so as one of the CFL's youngest coaches. Ladies and gentlemen, head coach of the Saskatchewan Roughriders, Corey Chamberlain.
From the minute it was announced the Riders and the province of Saskatchewan would host the 101st Grey Cup, Rider Nation could only dream about the possibility of their beloved team winning the Grey Cup at home. And entering his second season as head coach of the Rough Riders, Corey Chamberlain faced the pressure of leading a team with the weight of an entire province on his shoulders. But to make it to the Grey Cup in November, Chamberlain knew the hard work had to start in June. And when the Rough Riders season began in Edmonton, they flew out of the gate.
Touchdown, Corey Sheets!
The Riders started the season at 8-1, the best start in the franchise's 103-year history. However, the season did not come without its share of adversity. The Rough Riders' great start was quickly erased with 4 straight losses, and Chamberlain saw his team slip from first to third in the West Division. But Chamberlain put his trust in his players, led by quarterback Darian Durant. The Riders got back on track and reeled off 3 straight wins to secure second place in the West. After defeating BC in the Western semifinal, if the Rough Riders wanted to play one more game at home, they'd have to make the trip to Calgary and defeat the Stampeders in the very place where they suffered heartbreak only a year ago. And on a frigid day at McMahon Stadium, the Riders avenged their loss in last year's Western semifinal, defeating the Stampeders 35-13, giving Rider Nation the Grey Cup berth they'd always dreamt of. Before the game, Chamberlain addressed his team.
This team was built to win. This team went through everything it went through for this moment.
And playing in front of a sea of green, from the opening kickoff, the Rough Riders dominated the Tiger Cats, defeating Hamilton 45-23, winning the 4th Grey Cup in the franchise's history. For Chamberlain, it was his first Grey Cup as a head coach, and he delivered Rider Nation a memory that will last a lifetime.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage head coach of the Saskatchewan Rough Riders, Corey Chamberlain. Hey, coach. Quite a season, coach. Congratulations.
Thank you. And yes, it was.
It was indeed. You spent some time as a player in the NFL, had an opportunity to meet a pretty special coach yourself, I think, with Tampa Bay. Am Mike Tomlin was there at the time. Do we need to thank him for this path that you've taken to coaching?
You know what? There's actually a couple of guys, but you know, as far as opening the door and getting started, he was definitely one that lit that fire. And like I said, there's been a couple of guys since then that's actually helped me to be a head coach.
And I mean, Mike Tomlin, I mean, you're essentially following his model. Youngest head coach in NFL history, goes on to win the Super Bowl with the Steelers.
Yeah, that was awesome. Like I said, and it's something that when I look at now, you know, he made it possible to me. And, you know, there was a lot of times when I thought, that, hey, to be a coach, you had to be older and things like that. But he made the impossible look possible. And it was something that I took myself with the teams that I've been with and even now in this position. And it came possible.
Well, thank you, Mike Tomlin, because you've been doing a phenomenal job. We saw a little bit of the video story of the season. Coach, you come out the gate, you know, great start to the regular season. You hit a rough patch at one point. In a difficult season, you're hosting the Grey Cup. There's a lot of pressure on you, on your team. What was it that you said to your guys, or how did you manage to turn things around when it seemed to be sliding away?
You know, when I looked at the season, I look back on it, it was all about opportunities and obstacles and learning from those obstacles. And the biggest thing is, you know, we had some tough times there. You know, it was a very high, being 8-1, being one of the better teams in the CFL. And then I thought we had to have a correction period, and we didn't know when it would come, but it came, and we had some things that happened that ended up balancing us out. You know, sometimes you get a little bit too high. I don't think that was the case, but it did help us down the stretch. I think the biggest thing was, I think it was a BC game or something like that. It was later in the year, 4-game losing streak. That was the foundation for our year and going into the playoffs when we say, hey, enough's enough. We're one of the best teams in the CFL. Let's get it turned around.
And you sure did, and all the way to the Cup, to a
we
victory
did, yeah.
At home. One of the toughest things to do in professional sports, host a championship and win it at home. On that note, Coach, you'll be defending champions this year. As you start training camp in June, what do you say to your guys about the upcoming season, defending Grey Cup champions?
Well, you know, that's always good, and that's always, you know, 2013 was a good year for us, and we were the champions, and you are the defending champions, but it's a whole new year. It's a whole new atmosphere. You know, a lot of things have happened. There's a new team added to the league, so there's a lot of obstacles and opportunities that will mm-hmm. be there for 2014. I think the biggest thing is learn from everything we've been through that previous year, and hopefully it can carry over to another Grey Cup championship.
Well, we look forward to seeing it in action this year. All the best, Coach. Great season.
Thank you.
Best of luck today. Thank you, Coach. Well, our third finalist for Coach of the Year is now entering his seventh season, will be entering his seventh season as head coach of the Stampeders, and led his team this year, despite so many injuries, like Commissioner Cohan alluded to, to a 14-4 record. Ladies and gentlemen, head coach of the Calgary Stampeders, John Huffnagle.
A nominee for Coach of the Year for the second straight season, John.
I'll see if I can do Rod Smith's voice. John Huffnagle was. Oh, God. Well, you had a 14-4 season, for those of you who are...
A nominee for Coach of the Year for the second straight season, John...
Coach Huffnagle had a great season, despite so many injuries to some key players, like Nick Lewis. How can you go through a season without having Nick Lewis on your team? Well, he still managed to have a great season, finishing 14-4. He's been among the top coaches in our league season after season, and I'd like to welcome to the stage right now head coach of the Calgary Stampeders, Mr. John Huffnagle, ladies and gentlemen.
Sorry about that, Coach.
Coach, you've been with the Stamps.
First of all, I want to say, Corey, you broke the machine.
It was planned, Coach. It was planned. You've been with the Stamps going into your seventh season now. The Stamps, since you've been there, have always been at the top of the league, always fighting for that first place spot in the West. How do you do it year after year with the turnover that you get in the CFL?
Well, I'll talk about the turnover as far as the coaching staff, because we've had our share of turnover. And I've been very fortunate ever since I became a head coach in 2008 to be able to assemble a fantastic coaching staff. And when a person has left, I've have been able to either hire within the organization, or I've gone outside and hired very, very good coaches. A prime example is I lost my defensive coordinator this year. I think he became a head coach for this Ottawa.
Exactly. You're right about that.
Rick did a tremendous job for us for 2 years after Chris Jones left. You know, but then I was able to go out and acquire Rich Stubler. So it's something that you need to have a strong coaching staff to be able to survive an 18-game schedule with all the things and the problems that come with it.
It brings me right to my next question, Coach. I mean, this is always a big season, obviously, for the Stamps. But this year in particular, boy, the injury bug really caught up with you. I mean, how do you stay competitive in a season where you lose key players like that?
Well, every team deals with injuries, and we had our share, you know, but that's why you spend so much time in the offseason doing the due diligence, getting ready for the Canadian Football League draft. That's why you spend so much time in the States trying to, on your quest of finding new talent. So you do have a very competitive training camp, and you can build a team with some good depth. And when you do have an injury or two, those young players that have that opportunity to step on the field and make a play, well, the game's not too big for them. They're ready for it. And for the most part, our young guys have done excellent.
Phenomenal job. Finally, Coach, this year, I think, above any other, and I don't know if Marcel Desjardins planned it this way or not, we saw almost every backup quarterback in a starting role at some point or not. Right. Great for the Red Blacks, obviously, to get some tape on those guys. But how do you explain this year and how all these young quarterbacks seem to really answer the call when they were
Yeah, it was very exciting that these young guys came in, managed the game very well.
Oh, Levi Mitchell, I mean.
Yeah, but also they made plays to win the game. And I will say this, a lot of the young quarterbacks you're talking about played on good football teams.
True.
And Ken Austin and will be the first one to say it's a lot easier to play quarterback on a good football team than a not so good football team. But, you know, they did a tremendous job this year. The offensive coordinators did a great job of making putting these young players in a position to succeed. They didn't ask them to do the world. They just wanted them to execute the game plan, and they did. And it was good to see.
Coach, great season this year. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And all the best today. Thanks, Coach. Well, we're going to take a few minutes to get to my favorite portion of the day, the meal. So enjoy, and we'll be back shortly. Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody. Hope you all enjoyed your delicious meal. The time has finally come to present this year's Annis Stukus Award to the CFL Coach of the Year. To present this year's award, I'd like to invite to the stage the Commissioner of the Canadian Football League, le Commissaire de la Ligue canadienne de football, mesdames et messieurs, Mr. Mark Cohan.
I have it here, and I haven't opened it, so it's going to be a surprise for me, too. The 2013 CFL Coach of the Year is Corey Chamberlain from the Saskatchewan Roughriders.
I'll tell you, everyone they asked, they said, did you prepare your speech? And I'm like, I'm going against Kent and Huff. No, I didn't prepare one. Those guys are pretty tough. I'm telling you, to see them on the football field and to see them now, I have nothing but respect for those two guys. And it's something that's awesome to have my name mentioned with theirs. This is awesome. This is really awesome. You know, anytime you have an individual award, it's never about yourself. It's always about the people around you because they've done an excellent job. So, I'm very appreciative to receive this award, very humble to have my name mentioned, you know, with some of the greats that's been in this league, something that I always look back on, and hopefully my children can look forward to. So that's something that's awesome. Couldn't have done it without my coaches. Well, you know, it's about those guys, you know. As a head coach, we set the vision, and it's about the assistant coaches, and it's also about the players because they're the ones that carry that vision out. So I'm very proud of those guys on a daily basis for doing the things that they needed to do for us to accept this award. Also, you know, as I go down, like the voters, you know, I'm very thankful that you did pick me because, like I said, it was very tough, and I know it was a tough decision. You know, I've read and I've heard all the things that the other coaches have done, and I've you know, view them during the year. They've done an excellent job with their football clubs and overcoming adversity and also handling the successes that they had this year. So I'm very thankful that you voted for myself and for my coaches. I'd like to thank my head coach at home, my wife, who does all the hard work at home, who makes sure that I can just focus on football, you know, all day. And, you know, that's something that's good. I'd also like to thank my significant other at work, Brendan Tammen. you know, it's awesome. You know, I really appreciate this because, you know, I think it's a testament of, you know, the organization, you know, the vision that Jim has set and all those guys and us going forth. But Brendan being able to think out of the box a couple of years ago, handing the keys to a young assistant with no head coaching experience, believing that we can get a Grey Cup, and now even being the coach of the year. So this is something that I'm very pleased with, and I'm glad they're here to share in this moment with myself. And I'm very grateful to stand here for our organization. It was a very good year for us. I think this caps it off for us. And like I said, I'm just very excited. And I guess now getting to the individual names, you know, my mom and family for every day, making sure that the mindset that I have is about winning all day, every day. The assistant coaches, Gordy Mikey, Ivan, J.O., there are so many people, Shelly, Kim Mealy, and everyone at the back, Kevin Clive, just everyone. You know, just we're a Rider family, and I'm sorry if I missed anyone, but I'm telling you, I'm very excited, and this award is for all of us, but I'll keep it in my office. Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2013 CFL Head Coach of the Year, Corey Chamberlain. As Coach is taking his pictures, that's the end of our program today, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for being here. A quick thank you to the Ottawa Redblacks. The centerpieces that you see on your tables here today, the footballs are being given away to the National Capital Amateur Football Association for them. Some money raised today goes as well to NACAFA. Thank you to the Redblacks. Thank you, everyone, for being here, and enjoy the rest of the week.
Brody Lawson alongside Corey Chamberlain, Coach of the Year 2013. We're here in Ottawa, Ontario for the luncheon. Coach, how does it feel?
You know what? I feel pretty good. You know, it was one of those things I really didn't think I'd win because there were two pretty good guys there also, but I did win, and I'm excited for myself and my assistant coaches.
At the beginning of the season, you knew that the Grey Cup was going to be in Regina, and Rider Nation was watching you all season long. How did you handle that added pressure?
You know what? I told my wife this morning, I said, during this season, you don't think about it. You know, I guess it's more pressure when I look back on it. But during the season, it was just, let's go to work and let's see what happens. And like I said, the assistant coaches did a very good job of, when we stumbled, picking us back up.
You had guys like Sheets and Durant. Can you talk a little bit about this team and how they helped your success as a coach?
Well, you know, those guys, they came together as a team. That was the biggest thing in 2013. We matured. You know, Darren, he's been in a lot of big games, and some of them he didn't win. So he was ripe and ready for this year. Corey Sheets was ready to become who he was this year. So it was a lot for those guys just standing up and taking it where we ended up being.
On a day of reflection like this, a huge year, a great cup, Coach of the Year, who would you say your biggest, or what would your biggest influence be as a coach?
You know, as a coach, I've had so many influences. I really tell you, you know, I know a lot of people refer to Mike Tomlin. He's one of them. But in the CFL, you know, there is John Huffnagel. There's so many guys. Jim Barker was a guy that told me I'd be a better head coach than an assistant coach. You know, so there's a lot of guys. Chris Jones, a lot of guys that's who I've worked it and been around, who allowed me to see how to win. And, you know, I've learned those things, and now it's my own ship, and we're winning.
Hey, congratulations.
Thank you.
From the 2013 Coach of the Year Luncheon, I'm Brody Lawson for CFL.ca.